What's up, guys? Welcome to another open scene. Actually, today I'm gonna be talking about this scene here that I have made a couple of weeks ago. Last week I published it on Facebook and also on my Instagram, and I had a lot of requests about how I made this scene. So today I'm gonna show you all the tips and tricks that I use to create this scene. Okay, so let's get started. So here it is. I think the first question that should be asked is if I have modeled everything. No, I didn't model everything. I have modeled some parts, some piece of food that you can see scattered on the table. But most of the props, I got it from 3D Sky and Evermotion, and also the bridge, the Quicksilver bridge, okay, for plants and some of the foods you can see here, I got it from Bridge. Okay. Onside I downloaded, I had to adjust the textures because, as you know, every time you use or download models from 3D Sky or Evermotion, you have to retouch, let's say, the textures, right? So I had to do it in most of this, actually in all of this these props that you can see here. So I think this is the most painful work that I can say that I had in this image, in this composition. Okay, so let's take a look on the scene. So it's a pretty simple scene. Okay, I have a plain light here. This plain light has bitmap applied to it. Actually, I have used one of these softbox over here from, oh my god, I just forgot it. 3D Collective. So these ones are definitely a pretty good softbox. So I really recommend you guys, if you have a time, please go check it out, their websites. They have a really good stuff over there. So let's take a look on the render. Go into the camera and see the light result. Some people thought that this area over here was a little darker, and the reason I kept it dark is because I want it to be dark. Okay, I want to have this dramatic look to this scene. So this was the idea, the main idea. Also, I think this is a very important note here. Where I got this idea from, I got it from the PNM studio, and I really, again, recommend you guys have some time, go and check it out. This studio has a really, really nice image, and it's definitely one of my reference when I go check it out out there. And I always come here and see, this studio pay attention on the details, and this is something that's very important. So the vegetation, the water, everything. So it's very nice. Go check it out. It's very, very, very impressive. Okay. So I got it from there. This studio has a very similar image. So this was where it came from. Okay. So let's move on and see how I made this scatter food on the table. So I have separated a new scene here just to explain how I made that. Actually, it's very fun and I really recommend you guys as well to use it on your scenes. Definitely you have a lot of fun. Okay, so what I have made here, if I press spacebar on my keyboard, voila. So as you can see here, I have applied a rigid body to all these little geometries over here. Okay, so let me show you where it is. If you go here on the physics properties, you're gonna find it here on rigid body. Okay, so to make it work, actually you have to apply the rigid body on one piece of geometry and on the other one as well. For example, here we have the food and then we have the table. So on the table you have to apply it as well. Okay, so let's take a look on one piece here, this one. Let me just bring it up and let's apply a rigid body here. The table has a rigid body, and now if I press spacebar, yeah, here you go. It is. It's very fun. Check it out, guys. This rigid body here. I had a lot of fun. Definitely you will as well. Also, you can use it for a lot of things, like create a very nice and organic bowl of fruits. And I don't know, you can think more about that or have like more ideas, but yeah, this is like most of the time that when I'm creating a kitchen, for example, I always need a bowl of fruit, for example. So you can like get the fruits from, I don't know, Quixel and just import it on Blender and then create a bowl and apply rigid body for everything and then press bar space and that's it. You have like a very organic bowl of fruits for you to use on your kitchen. So definitely there is a lot of different ideas to use it, but yeah. So that's it, guys. I hope you have enjoyed it. And if you like, please subscribe to my channel. Also, leave your message as well. I'll be glad to answer as soon as I can. And yeah, thank you very much, guys. And see you in the next video.